and welcome back to another episode of Unsung. I'm Mark Hopkins, your host. I want to thank everybody for the feedback. You can get us online at unsung.us. And we're on Facebook, Twitter, all that stuff. And today we have guests, our second politician, our first state politician, I think, State Representative Kate Harper. One of my observations, I've dealt with her off and on over the years, and I've dealt with her through other people on the search and rescue team. Always accessible, very direct and straightforward. The reason I got the idea to have her on the show was we were I was out before my show with another guest, and I was listening to her talk on another show, and I said, that person in the room is pretty smart. They seem to know what they're talking about. And then she came out, and then to prove that I'm not smart, I didn't recognize her, didn't know who she was having met her before. But we straightened all that out, and now we've got her on the show, and thank you for coming.
I'm happy to be here.
What motivates you to get started in politics?
Well, I have to say, it's a long time ago now, but to put it in context, I was out of law school, newly married, no kids, and I ride horses for fun. And every day we would ride, maybe once a week we would ride, but every time we'd go out, we would see another farm had been plowed under and there were houses being built, or, you know, a subdivision going in, or big changes in our community. And me and my friends began to go to the township meetings and planning commission meetings mainly and say, can we have a trail along the edge of this new development? Or can we have any of the development can be saved as open space? And that this was the 80s. Those were new concepts in Montgomery County. And we really found that the communities that were being developed very rapidly at that point were surprised by it. They hadn't done a comprehensive plan in 20 or 30 years. They hadn't updated their zoning ordinances. They really, as one elected supervisor said to me, well, we don't need more parks. Everybody has a big backyard. And that was literally true. But the world was changing around us, and it seemed to me that the folks in local government were making decisions, and they didn't really see what was coming. So first thing I did was start to attend planning commission meetings and zoning board meetings and speak up, ask questions, and give my opinion as a citizen. And I was so faithful at attending the Lower Gwynedd Planning Commission that the supervisors put me on it when they had an opening. And I served for a year. Then there was an opening on the Board of Supervisors, and you have to run for that. And I was encouraged to run, and I did. And I had no intentions of getting into politics and no intentions of doing a political job or an elected office job. And, of course, at the local level, the elected office job is basically a part-time job, something you do at night after you finish your real job or whatever. So it fit in with being a young lawyer. And I enjoyed it, and I especially enjoyed the ability to get things done. When we started in Lower Gwynedd, we had a 2.5-acre park that had been donated by the Ingersolls. When we finished, we had over 100 acres. And we had miles and miles of trails, not just for horse people, but for walkers and joggers and bicyclists and people with dogs. And I saw that by getting involved and speaking up, you really can make a difference.
You know, it's funny that part of what I think makes the town reps good is what you said there, is that it's a part-time job, so they still have – they're not a career politician. They're still working, and they're still out there doing the day-to-day things, and they don't lose touch with reality. And I think that the higher you go up with any business, and if politics is a business in some ways, you lose a little bit of touch with day-to-day reality. So it's good that they keep that contact in the beginning. And it sounds like you've been doing this over 30 years, if I can say that. And
yeah, I think that's about right.
and you've – moved up. You didn't come in the middle of it. You started at the bottom.
At the bottom.
And not really planning on doing it. And that's really the people that have passions for the jobs are the ones that are accidental tourist, as it were, you know.
Right. I actually divide the world of political people or elected officials into two groups. Those who run to be somebody. I want to be governor. I want to be president. I want to be senator, whatever. And those who run to get things done. And I fall into the latter category. I believe that at different levels, you can do different things. I could, for example, save open space and parks in Lower Gwinnett by being a township supervisor. I could save parks in Montgomery County by joining the County Planning Commission and working on the county's open space plan. And I can save parks and open space and farms and forests all over Pennsylvania by getting elected to the state legislature. So I think if the elected person or the candidate has a focus on what they want to do as opposed to what they want to be, I think you can get things done.
Well, you know, and it's there's a lot of wisdom there because there's also an age thing that I see some people. I mix emotions when I see very young politicians because it makes me hopeful. But I also wonder, do you truly have the experience that goes with the responsibility that's put before you? And I'd rather see somebody with a little more life experience. You know, I think that there's a time for everything. And, you know, it would be nice if we could if we could live life backwards with our wisdom and, you know.
Right.
Like that movie. When you started, who mentored you?
I have always had a series of mentors. The head of our Republican Party in the township was a woman named Del Rotelli. And she was supportive of women generally and supportive of me. But also, because I am a practicing lawyer still, although I only do it part-time now, I had a lot of lawyers over the years who I would talk to and get their ideas, and I learned things from them. I learned, for example, from a lawyer who did real estate development, that you can't zone out anything. What you have to do is if you really want that land to be open, you have to make a commitment to buy it because that farmer's field is his retirement account. And he deserves the right to be able to sell it or use it like anybody else's retirement account when he's too old or too tired to be milking the cows twice a day. So from that, I learned that if you want to save open space, you have to be able to raise money, you have to pick the right open space, you have to be able to make deals, and you have to get it done. And I think that that's a consequence of listening to people who are out there in the real world, as opposed to the political world, which is not always the real world, and getting things done and living their lives. So to your point that local government officials, and they're the ones who are going to be running this year, have daily and lifetime experience that they can bring to bear on how to run your borough, how to run your town, how to run your township or county, I think that is a very good thing. And I think that people should not be discouraged if they feel they're too old to get into this. They're not. They're probably hitting their prime.
Yeah, I think that there's a lot of people that are hitting their prime, what we would have considered later, you know, a few years ago, health-wise and mentally. And I see a lot of people. I encourage people, you know, as long as you can physically without jeopardizing your health, help however you can, however you're comfortable with you. And that's part of what got me started with wanting to do this show is I felt a lot of people, emergency services, were taking a lot of wisdom with them that the current generation is not getting because they get a lot off of Googling stuff and looking on YouTube rather than sitting and talking to somebody that actually did it. And why not avail yourself to that?
And we're living longer, so we can live longer, more productive lives. And sometimes you have more time later. When you're a young mother and you're working as a lawyer and you have a couple of kids, as I did, it's actually very, very difficult to be involved in your community because it takes time from other things. But when the kids are out and I often joke that if I didn't have Facebook, I wouldn't know where my two sons are these days because they're too busy to call mom. But at this stage in my life, I have more time as well. So I think people can, you know, have a lot to offer and a lot of wisdom. And I also think that the local stuff, the local history, the local experience is not on the internet.
No, no, and it's the nuances of it, and it doesn't capture any. You can't catch your emotion and inflection in the same way on there and everything. I believe that when you put a camera into an environment, it changes the environment, and the internet being introduced has changed the whole reception of the message. But, you know, you should be thankful that you're apparently you're two boys have Facebook friended you, and I know many parents, that's a battle to get their children to even friend them.
Well, my boys are 28 and 30, off on their own careers, so they're busy, Mom, but I do follow them on Facebook, and that does help me see where they are.
Well, just do what I did with my nephew and post embarrassing pictures of them when you want them to call.
Then they'll unfriend me, so I'm not doing that.
When you got started, what was one of the first lessons you remember? Are there any lessons that stand out early on about being a politician?
Yes. I think one of the first things you have to learn is that there's never only one vote. Whatever the vote is, you will be dealing with these same people at the very least for 2 years or 4 years or 6 years or maybe for the rest of your life. And also I learned that if you want something done, the best way to do it is two people talking to each other face to face. You might be able to convince them of your position, or you might be able to understand their position, but you have to talk to each other face to face. Now, I like Facebook. I use it all the time. But I have to say a virtual community is not the same as a real community. And, you know, every day you drive down a street and it annoys you that you can't make a left because there's no left turn arrow. That's your local government working with PennDOT that can fix that. And so it's your local elected officials who need to know about it. And you need to talk to them. And maybe they can fix it very easily and they will want to do it. So to all your listeners, I would hope that they would either consider showing up at a township meeting just to see what's going on, or borough meeting just to see what's happening, or running themselves. We're almost into petition season now, so people will be going around trying to collect signatures to get on the ballot, and then they'll be running this year. We have local elections and judgeships this year. So this is a good time to think about getting involved in your local government. And if you're nervous about it or you don't know if you'll like it, go to the township or the borough and say, I'd like to volunteer. I'd like to serve on the planning commission or the library board. They're always looking for people. And it's important, you know, to get involved and to see what your community's like and how it works. And of course, a plug for those who are physically able, either search and rescue like you do, or local volunteer fire companies are always looking for people. To my surprise, they told me that they not only look for the physically fit who can help fight fires and run into burning buildings, they also look at people who can keep the books for the fire company and submit the applications for the grants and make sure that they're filing all the paperwork they have to file.
Oh, absolutely. Anybody that can get to the building, there's a way they can help, you know, with any of these organizations. And sometimes, even when they can't get to the building because of electronic communications, there's options for them to help. So anybody who wants to help, a volunteer organization worth its salt will find a way for you to help. So you're exactly right about that. And, you know, it's funny. I was telling somebody the other day, they have signs out. They used to have signs that say volunteers want it in front of the firehouses. And I just watched those signs change. And it's subtle, but it says volunteers need it now, want it, need it, because it is getting a little desperate, because the generation that did it, that was immersed their life into it, that generation is getting up there, and the next generation's got to step up, or else there's going to have to be some paid solution, which is going to make taxes skyrocket.
Right, but sometimes the problem is the one generation's moving.